Thank you so much for coming out this afternoon. We are invading the 2nd Congressional District with members of our family. We've got about a dozen of them here today. We've been in the eastern part of the district. Now we're headed towards the western part of the district. And of course, the centerpiece of all of that is being here in Apalachicola. We had a great opportunity to canoe on the river. What a beautiful day to be in a place that God has given us with such beauty and warmth as this community and this great river. I want to thank all of you for being here and giving Gwen and the family a chance to meet you, and I hope that you will like what you're going to see, and that you will feel that this is the kind of person that you would like to be able to say, this is my congresswoman. And I might say, Gwen would be the first woman to ever represent this part of Florida in the U.S. Congress. And to help her get elected, this is going to be an election which, yes, there'll be ads, there'll be bumper strips, there'll be signs, all the things that you're used to. But what's really going to count is who gets out to vote on November the 4th. This is going to be an election, one-by-one voter driven. So first, I am going to assume that all of you who are here who are over the age of 18, and there are a few that I look like they're over 18, are registered. And that on November the 4th, not only will you use your right and privilege to vote, but also that you will encourage your friends and neighbors to vote. This is an election in which I hope we'll begin a process of restoring people's confidence in their national government. There's been so much partisanship and gridlock. And it's not just one party or the other. I'm afraid the whole system has become almost dysfunctional. And the way to turn that around is to change the kind of people who are in the Congress, to elect people who aren't there in order to scream and yell about their ideology, but are there to try to understand what the American people want and what are some reasonable answers to their desires. That's what Congress is when it's functioning best, and it will be functioning a lot better when Gwen Graham is representing the second. But it's not going to happen unless good people get to the polls on November the 4th and encourage other good people to do likewise. We are so pleased to get back to Apalachicola, one of my favorite cities in Florida. It's a city that is deep in the history of this state. Gwen's running on a commitment to the North Florida way. I don't think there's a place in North Florida that more represents what those values that are special to this part of the world are than Apalachicola. And I thank you for your contribution to the continuance of that heritage and tradition of Franklin County and Apalachicola. And it's my privilege, you've already met my wife. I'm gonna ask if the other members of the Graham family who are here, including some of our grandchildren, where did they? We even have our dog. Privilege to introduce someone that I have known for all of her 51 years plus 9 months, and am so proud of what she has accomplished in life and what she brings to her aspiration to serve you in the United States Congress. I can tell you from up close and personal, I know she will be an outstanding member of the United States Congress, you'll be proud to have her as your representative. Friends, my daughter, Gwen Graham.